Hello, this is the RPG Chick, and welcome to Let's Play Stories Untold. This is a, well, indie game that was released earlier this year, 2017, by a developer named No Code. These are four separate games. Some of them have to do with, like, a text adventure, and others I've been told not. Options are not much. Reset the save file. I played a little bit of the first one, just a tiny bit, like I'll tell you when I get to the point at which I have not played. I don't even know what that is. Unlock all levels. Subtitles I switched on, and that's it. In all fairness, well, they should have included a audio slider of some kind, but there's nothing. But in all fairness, they did put a little launcher, you know, a box on your desktop where you can choose the graphics quality, which is only low, medium, and high, and you can choose your resolution. And so, and you can bind certain keys. But an audio slider would have been nice. This is a quiet game, at least in this part. So I have my mic all the way up pointed at my eye, believe it or not, and I normally do not have it that far up. It's just because the game volume is all the way up, and you'll see what I mean. I cannot make it any louder. I mean, I can boost the mic. I guess I could lower the volume of the mic, but I decided to just put it up as it is. So, yeah, starting with the house abandoned. I've been told that this game does not have any jump scares or things chasing you. It is kind of like horror themed, but I have a problem with games like that. But as long as nothing is chasing me or jumping out at me, I'm pretty much fine. I enjoy the atmosphere of some games, just, you know, the only thing that gets me is the chasing and the jump scares, or the anticipation and suspense of waiting for such a thing to happen. It's really low, the music. That's what I'm saying. I've played a lot of games, and never have I seen a game this low. Okay, so you see there, we've got, like, some kind of Apple computer hooked up to a regular TV set, apparently. Wood grain. I like the photos. And the phone in the background. I don't like that sound. So we're 10:05 p.m. Hopefully you guys can read this right. So of course I'm recording and uploading this in 1080p, so see, I can barely read the house abandoned by No Code because it's just in an offset. So this is what the first game is, apparently. And you can move a little. Can I click anything? I can't interact with anything, apparently. You can move around just a little bit, like I said. So I read all the things, so I'm going to be reading everything that appears. So, such as this. So if you guys don't like people who read all the things, well, sorry. Now, I have not played the game. What does it say? Tape loader. I had, much later, after it came out, my uncle gave me his used Commodore PET computer when it was already, like, I don't know, like at least 5-6 years old. It was an old computer by then, but I enjoyed playing with it, and I was amazed that you use a tape drive and not, you know, a floppy disk. But so that's the only computer I have knowledge with. Was it, say, Futuro? It's the only game. I know others did. I think Commodore 64 did. So I guess this most resembles a Commodore 64 or an Apple IIe or something like that. You pull up to the driveway of the family holiday home and park the car. It's dark, but it's as idyllic as you remember from all that time ago. You remember being told to look in the glove box before going in. It's good to be back. Now, we're really limited here. Look at car. It's a nice, clean car. Not much to see, but there is a glove box. So forgive my horrible typing skills, because I'm looking at the monitor. I don't know what you're looking at. Look at driveway. We're pulled up to the driveway. Why not look at it? So I think you can just go look box. The glove box is closed, but appears to be unlocked. Inside is a key and a handwritten note from Dad. You take both. So now we have a key and a note. Inventory. Does not understand. You have two items, but there's no... I mean, there's an inventory, but you can't look at it. So, look. We don't have to type at, so at least there's at. It's the key to the house. It also doesn't understand X, exam, or examine for look at things. So it's really just look, as far as I know. I wonder if this will work. Nope. No abbreviations. So... The note is from your dad and reads, "Hi, son. Hope you enjoy your break. You'll need to fire up the generator around back to get power and lights on. Also, found something in the attic for you. It's in your room. Enjoy." Fire up the generator around back. And it's just repeating. You can't even type while it's doing that. Exit car. You open the car door and step out. The house is grand, set perfectly amongst the trees. In front of you is the front door, and the yard stretches around the side of the house. So now, can we look at the house? It wouldn't let me look at the house before. I don't think I tried it in this playthrough, but when I was messing around. The lights are all off, and no one else is here. Look at the door. The door appears to be locked. Look at the yard. The spacious yard extends around to the back of the house, a great place to relax in a long summer. Now, things you think would work, like help. Hint. Doesn't understand. There's a bunch of other things. There's a few other things that don't work. That should. So, as an interpreter, this is sorely lacking, I'm afraid. The yard stretches around to the side of the house. Go. So we don't understand north, south, east, etc. Go to side. Oh, that's bad. Side of house. You don't understand, guys. These clunky keys. You can hear them, I'm sure. The door appears to be locked. You will need to use a key. I'm trying to go over to the side of the house. The yard stretches around the side of the house. Go to yard. You take a walk around to the yard. Okay, cool. The yard has been well maintained. You spent a lot of time here with your family on holiday trips. Good memories. Look. The other thing is you can't use the up arrow to repeat keys. That would have been helpful. Look, yard. You see a generator on the back wall of the house. Now, the only thing I did, I have not been here. This is blind. I went in the house, tried to switch, and found it to be not working. And that's it. That's all I played. So I really just unlocked the door, went in, tried the light switch. I'm like, okay, this is how this game goes. And let us, like, record now. You see a generator on the back wall. Okay, look. Generator. The fuel gauge is healthy, and it is manually operated. Okay. Turn on the generator. You switch the generator on, and it whirs to life. The house is still dark. All right. Anything else I need to do here with the generator? The fuel gauge is healthy and it is manually operated. Look. Gauge. Well, it's still dark because we haven't flipped the switch on, I guess. So, go to... how about... front door. Can I just go right to the front door? You walk back around to the front of the house. And stuff that we have to wait for. Okay, so... unlock... I wonder... you know, I'm wondering if it'll stop me here. Or if it'll... you'll need to... yeah, okay. We manually have to unlock it. Unlock door. You insert the key and turn. The door lock clicks open. Click! And we have to separately open the door. I'm sure it doesn't understand things like unlock door and open it. That's like what modern interpreters could understand. Even Zork and stuff could understand that, I believe. You enter the house to the hallway. It's dark and you can't see anything. You feel a light switch next to the door, however. Testing the limits here. Can doesn't understand flick switch. It doesn't know flick. Or it doesn't know switch. I hope it knows switch, because that's a switch. Turn on switch. I don't know what you're trying to use. Turn on lights? You said it's a switch. You flick the switch and the lights come on. The hallway is now brightly lit. There is access to the kitchen and living room here, as well as a set of stairs going up. Now we don't understand commands, like directionals, so I have to separately go to places, which is weird. Alright. We've got living room and kitchen. Go to kitchen. You walk into the kitchen. The kitchen is tidy and well kept. There is a door to a utility room, but otherwise it's just a kitchen. Nothing to look at in the kitchen? You sure? Go to utility room. I'm sorry, I don't understand. Did I spell something wrong? Go to utility. It's been understanding go to. The utility room is doors locked. You have no idea where the key could be. I don't suppose it's the key I already used. The key doesn't fit in the utility room door. Okay. Look at the door. Any clues? Nope. Nope. Okay. Alright, so go to living room. I'm sorry, I don't understand. Go... living, right? Everything is spelled correctly. Go to living room. God, go to front. I have to go from the front door? Go to front door. I'm trying to get back out the kitchen. Exit kitchen. Go back out to the hallway. Thank you very much. Living room. Go to living room. You step inside the living room. Now it understands in some, I guess, next to it. A spacious and comfortable living room. We spent a lot of good time in here playing board games with the family. Warm and inviting. And... don't suppose this will work. There's nothing here of interest. Look. I know it doesn't understand this. Get all. Doesn't say there's board games here now, but there was... once was. Look at living room. I don't suppose I'll find anything else. There's nothing here of interest. Okay. Exit. Okay, just type exit. Okay, good. Thank you. Now, I don't suppose I can just go up. up, go upstairs. You walk upstairs to the landing, the stairwell landing. There is a bathroom and two bedrooms, yours and your sister's. Should be a quote there or whatever, what do you call it? Pictures adorn the walls. Images of happy times. Okay, so we got bathroom, my bedroom, sister's bedroom. Look, pictures. Family photos and holiday snaps. Our happy family. Alright. Go to bathroom. I'm saving my room for last. You step inside the bathroom. You are in the bathroom. There's not much to note, but it's all in good order. Okay. Nothing? The bathroom is clean. A large mirror sits above the sink. Okay, so look around does reveal other things. Look at... I know, at is optional. Look at mirror. It's your reflection. Looking good. I don't suppose this would work. Look at me. Sorry, I don't know what you're looking at. Now, you can't even... It doesn't even understand quit. Some interpreter. Load game, right? Load. These are obvious things would be in. I wouldn't really expect this stuff to be in here. It's just... I like to test the limits of some such things. And laugh. And this doesn't understand. I wonder if there's something else in the... kitchen? Yeah, I don't even know. So, exit. I assume we're going back to the kitchen anyway. Because to get in that utility room. So I'll hopefully remember to check then. Go to sister's bedroom. You walk into your sister's old room. Your sister's room is in perfect condition. Untouched since the last time you had seen her. Posters of her heroes and some of her own attempts at art adorn the walls. Oh, there's a lot. Big description. Largest description, right? A few shelves are crammed full of trophies. Her bed is drowned under a pile of colorful soft toys. A real nostalgia trip. Posters. Let me guess. John Bon Jovi. Posters of all her favorite pop stars mixed with some of her own art. She was pretty good. Look at art. Same description. Look at trophies. She won a lot of trophies for dance and gymnastics. Talented girl. Look at toys. Every soft toy she has ever owned. Look at bed. It's difficult to see the bed for all the soft toys. Okay. Got the hint there. Move toys. I'm sorry, I don't understand. Get toys. You wouldn't dare touch anything in here. She would kill you. She is not here. Anyone who moved her stuff... It wasn't me. It was Michael Myers. Clear bed? No. Yeah, I'm just not sure... The fact it's telling me I can't see it because the toys are in the way makes me think I can move the toys. We've been playing this for a while. It's still 10:05. Look under toys. Look under bed. Okay, I give up. go. Can't do. Go to. If I type in bedroom, is it going to go to my room? Which bedroom? Your room or your sister's? Go to my room. I was going to put, be a smart ass and put your room. You walk into your old room. Your old bedroom. So many good memories in here, and it's been preserved so well. On the desk is a gift-wrapped box. Anything else besides the box? It's a standard bedroom. A desk, a wood-grain TV, the usual. Look at the desk. Your good old desk. A little dusty, but still very sturdy. Look, TV. A good few years now, but it still works like new. And that was it, right? Just those two things? Look around. The usual. I don't suppose there's a bed in here. It's a standard bed. Okay. A large gift wrap present. The tag says your name. What's my name? Open box. What's in the box? You unwrap the gift excitedly. You can't believe it. Dad has found your old computer. A Futuro 128K plus 2. Okay, that's what we're looking at here. It's been preserved well in the attic and hopefully still works. Your old bedroom. Okay, blah blah blah. On your desk is a Futuro 128K plus 2 computer and a copy of The House Abandoned. It's all still to be set up though. Okay. That's an awkward sentence. Okay, so we can play the game inside a game. Look at the computer. It's a Futuro 128K plus 2 with tape loader and a copy of The House Abandoned. Look at House Abandoned. It's a standard bedroom. Oh, now there's a clock. Well, I can see the clock on top of the TV, but there's a phone. Can I can't look at these things that are obviously right in front of me, but no, look at pictures. Set up computer. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to be doing here. Plug computer into monitor. You start to plug in the various cables and leads. The computer is all set up and ready to go. There's a game here too. Yes, I am aware. The Future Abandoned. I mean the House Abandoned. Not the Futuro Abandoned. Play the House Abandoned. I don't know what you're trying to use. Play game. You don't know the name of your own game? You put the cassette in the player and press play. Ooh!